I'll be on vocals and acoustic guitar tonight. To my left is Ella with vocals. On my right here is Dave on vocals and acoustic. Next to Dave is Brianna with vocals and bass guitar. And behind us, center stage, is Rachel playing the kit. We're so blessed to be standing up here tonight worshiping God with you. We come from different churches, different denominations, different cities, different backgrounds. But one thing's consistent, and that is our love of our God. Tonight we're going to have a ton of fun. We want to hear you sing loud all night long. Your energy feeds us, so bring it all night long, please. So let's begin tonight by joining hands in prayer. Lord, thank you for bringing us all together tonight. You love us so much that you gave us everything. Tonight we ask that you open our hearts and minds to celebrate you together as one. Tonight we show that we are one as we pray the prayer that unifies us all. The prayer you taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. All right, so let's get this thing rolling. Are you guys ready? All right, let's go. As the Spirit was moving over the water, Spirit, come move over us. Come rest on us. Come rest on us. As the Spirit was moving over the water, Spirit, come move over us. Come rest on us. Come rest on us. So come down, Spirit, when you move, you make my heart pound. When you fill the room,
conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King.
Oh, so, so thankful to have all of these people, all these believers, people who love Jesus together in this room. God, I have prayed for this night, for this moment, for years. Thank you, God, for what you're doing in Hawley, Minnesota. You are starting something new, and you started long ago in each of our hearts and minds. We thank you so much, God. We want to declare tonight from the center of this city that you are God, you are great, you are mighty. I will sing unto the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously, the horse and the rider thrown into the sea. The Lord liveth, and blessed be the rock, and may the God of my salvation be exalted. How great is our God.
How great is our God?
is our God, and oh, we'll sing how great, how great is our God.
So each Sunday for the past year or two, the first thing that I do when I get to church is kneel in prayer. Typically, my prayer is to thank God for keeping me and my family safe and healthy and for giving us so many amazing blessings. I ask God to keep us safe through the next week, and then I ask Him to help me open my heart and calm my mind so that I can hear how I can best use the blessings He's given me to spread His word. About 4 or 5 months ago, I was sound asleep taking a really great nap. When I sleep, I pretty much always play music. So on this particular day, I woke up from a deep sleep because I hear a song playing that I'd never heard before. And I hear the lyrics in my sleep, and I woke up to hear. So I throw up my hands and praise you again and again. I know it's not much, but I've got nothing else fit for a king except for my heart singing hallelujah. So the lyrics go on to say, I've got just one move, and that's to throw up my arms and sing hallelujah. I couldn't get this beautiful song out of my head, so I immediately got up, grabbed my guitar, and I learned the song for about the next 2 hours. I didn't know why this song struck me so hard, but as I played it over and over again, I felt the urge to play this song to more people. At that point, I started to connect the dots. God is answering my prayer that I pray each Sunday. Let me hear you when you tell me how I can use the blessings that I've been given to spread His word. So that's how this concert came to be. I texted Dave and Brianna almost immediately and asked them if they'd join me. And the part that topped it off was what Brianna responded to me with. Brianna, if you wouldn't mind sharing.
2 weeks before that, I had been walking through Westgate Park on Night to Unite, and Cody was playing the guitar and singing. 3 years prior to that, I had started to pray that I wanted to be in a Christian worship rock band. And I didn't want to be the one to put it together. So we were walking through Westgate on Night to Unite, and I walked by Cody, and he was singing, and God tapped my shoulder and said, this is going to be a part of what I'm doing in this town and in your life. And the next week, we looked at Garrett Theater, Chris and I did. And the week after that, Cody sent me the message.
So God works in crazy ways. And all we have to do is calm our minds and open our hearts and listen. This next song is called Gratitude.
With my arms stretched wide, You've got a lion inside of those lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. So come on, my soul. Oh, don't you get shy on me. Lift up your song. 'Cause you've got a lion inside of those lungs. Get up. Your song, 'cause you've got a lion inside of those lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. Hey, yeah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So I throw up my hands, praise you again and again. 'Cause all that I have is a hallelujah, hallelujah. And I know it's not much, I've nothing else paid for my King, except for a heart.
These two are so talented, they're bored playing their original instruments. They're going to switch.
gonna see of the goodness of God. I will see of the goodness of God. I will see of the goodness of God. Give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your
breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, pour out our praise, it's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out.
right, so isn't it crazy to think that with 7 billion people in this world, God knows everything about you. He knows what you've done. He knows what you will do. And every one of you in this room, He knows personally. His love for each of you is unmatched. I don't know about you, but with so many people in the world, sometimes I can feel insignificant or like another number. But even though I may stray from time to time, God cares so much about me that He accepts me for who I am and always has open arms waiting for me. This next song has some pretty powerful lyrics that I want to read. The song says, "Who am I that the King of the world would give one single thought about my broken heart? Who am I that the God of all grace wipes the tears from my face and says, 'Come as you are'? You paid the price, you took the cross, you gave your life, and you did it all with me on your mind." In this world of so much chaos, so much pain and suffering, I know that I've got a God who cares so deeply about me individually and each of you individually that He died for us on the cross. And that's pretty dang awesome. That's got to put a smile on your face. Let's join in singing this next one called "Me on Your Mind."
I've read the words in red. You leave the 99 to find the one missing. Feels like that was written with me on your mind. And the prodigal son who ran, leaving his home behind, the part where the father came running to meet him, did you say that with me on your mind? Who am I?
Yeah.
God is doing something. Right now, He is up to something. He is up to something. God is doing something. Right now, He is saving someone. He is saving someone. God is doing something right now. Right now, He is healing someone. He is saving someone. God is doing something right now. Right now, He is moving mountains, making a way for someone. God is doing something right now. Right now, He is moving mountains, making a way for someone. God is doing something right now. Right now, He is moving mountains, making a way for someone. God is doing something right now. Right now, He is moving mountains, making a way for someone. God is doing something right now. All of my hope is in the name of Jesus. Dark. darkness rejoiced as though heaven had lost. But then Jesus arose with all freedom in hell. That's when death was arrested in my life being. All your dreams so free washes over me. You have made us new, now life begins with you. It's your
is a newer rendition of the old hymn, It Is Well. So it's a little bit different parts, some different stuff bolted on, but the chorus remains the same. So I wanted to tell the story of this song. Some of you have maybe heard me tell it before, so you just got to sit through it again. Sorry. So this song was written by Horatio Spafford back in like the late 1800s. So in 1871, he was like a lawyer and a real estate investor in Chicago. He and his wife, Anna, had 5 kids, 1 boy, 4 girls. Tragically, a 4-year-old boy dies of scarlet fever in 1870. Not incredibly uncommon, you know, that long ago. So they're dealing with that, right? Then in 1871, the Great Chicago Fire happens, burns 2,000 acres of the city of Chicago. So any farmers in the room have a pretty good mental idea of what 2,000 acres is, and real estate agents probably. But for the rest of us, it's like 2,000 football fields minus the end zones. That's a lot of burn down. So he's a real estate guy, right? Most of his financial wealth is wiped out. What's left? 2 years later, there's a financial crisis, kind of a bank run panic deal, whatever. Another hit to his finances. So they had 3 big whacks right in a row, and he decides, okay, I think we should take a vacation. So he decides that his family is going to take a vacation in England, and partially to go visit a preacher friend of his that lives there. So they leave Chicago, head to New York. He gets hung up with some work stuff. He says, you guys go ahead. It's all good. I'll catch up with you when I'll catch up with you there. So wife, 4 daughters, sailing to England. 2 a.m., their ship collides in the dead of night with another ship. Within 12 minutes, the ship has sunk. All 4 of his girls drown. And his wife, Anna, is unconscious, found unconscious later on just a piece of debris floating in the ocean. Miraculously rescued. So she gets to England eventually after they fix all the wreckage, whatever. She sends a telegram back home. Saved, but saved alone. What shall I do? So just take a second and imagine getting that as a telegram and just the complete panic and anxiety that would probably ensue, knowing you can't, you know, nowadays we can call that person, text that person, whatever. So he gets that message. He sets sail for England. And the boat captain calls him out to the bridge of the ship, says he's got to tell him something, and he tells him, we're sailing right over the spot where your wife and daughters all went down. So, anyway, he heads back to his room after that and writes the lyrics to the hymn, It Is Well, which is pretty profound to think about after everything that he just went through. So, as we sing the next song, I would just encourage you to think about those lyrics as we sing them, and think about them in the context of Horatio and Anna's story, and think about these, what these words would have meant to them. And yeah, it's a 150-year-old song. It's, I think, just as powerful today as it was the day it was written. So, Ella's Corner over here. If you liked her on that last one, just wait for this one. Thank you.
Things that need to be well with your soul. We are singing this over you today.
The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you. Shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
Amen. Amen. we serve. We know from your word that the curses go down to the generation, but your blessings, the blessings that we just prayed over this room and over this town, they go to the generations and the generations and the generations. You are so good. And God, we face things and we've dealt with things in our lives. I think about this next song that we're going to sing, and when this came out on the radio, Chris was in a hospital bed, and we had no idea how we were going to get to the other side of that mountain. And that is what is so incredible about being your child, that it doesn't matter what life looks like. It doesn't matter if we're in a hospital bed. It doesn't matter if our bank account says zero. Whatever we're faced with, nothing can ever take away the blood that Jesus shed for us on the cross. Nothing can ever take away that we are saved by faith in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you that you give us the power to walk in boldness, to speak your truth, to bring peace into this world. God, everything could be taken from me and stripped from me. There's nothing, nothing that's better than you.
I have a cramp in my armpit. First time for everything.
Here we go now.
We worship the God who was. We worship the God who is. We worship the God who evermore will be. He opened the prison doors. He parted the raging sea. My God, He holds the victory.
And Brianna for allowing us to use this beautiful venue. To those who helped this show function, we got Justin and Brett behind the curtain here, making everything work. And to you for joining us. Have a great night. Travel home safely. Praise God for all we continue to be blessed with. Good night.
is spreading like a wildflower in my heart. A Sunday morning, hallelujah, and it's lasting all week long.
So much. We really appreciate it. Have a great night. Travel home safe. God bless.